How's it going, everybody? This is Seth Isaacson with Rock Island Auction Company, here to talk to you today about some of the items coming up in our April 24th through the 26th Premier Firearms Auction. Everything you see on the table today comes from the Versailles Manufactory underneath Nicolas Noël Boutet, who is arguably one of the best firearms makers in French history. In 1788, with his marriage, Boutet became gunmaker in ordinary to King Louis XVI. Then after that, he actually became the artistic director of the Versailles Manufactory, which manufactured both arms for the military and deluxe presentation arms like you see here. And then from there, he became the overall director. Underneath his direction, over 600,000 arms, including swords and firearms, were manufactured, and he had over 800 workmen at his disposal. So as you can tell, his style kind of evolved over time. Earlier on, you're going to have firearms that are more similar to the style that would have been made underneath the Bourbon kings. And then later on, you're going to have what's called the Empire style, which became popular after the rise of Napoleon. You're going to see more Greco-Roman influence on the later pieces, whereas the earlier pieces are going to have a little more of the Baroque and Rococo style, which is a little more floral and ornate. So this pair of pistols here at the center are obviously the most lavish pair in this set. They were manufactured by Boutet at Versailles, but you can't really tell that on first glance. There are no external markings that would tell you that. However, on a lot of the really high-end presentation pieces, you'll actually find the manufactory markings and the Boutet markings primarily on the inside of the locks and the underside of the barrels, which is the case on these pistols. If you look in our catalog and online, you can actually see the close-up images of those markings. So these pistols were presented to Captain Cesar-Joseph Bourayne. He had a long and distinguished career in the French Navy, both under the French monarchy and underneath Napoleon. He first served during the American Revolution on a ship of the line at the Battle of the Chesapeake and the Battle of the Saints when he was just a teenager, and then rose up through the ranks until he was in command of his own ship. As captain of the Cannoneer in 1806, he headed to the Ile de France, now Mauritius, in the Indian Ocean and battled the British. These pistols were presented to him by merchants from the Ile de France in September 1808 after he defeated the British HMS Laurel, which stopped by the island to drop off French women captured on a prize ship. While the Laurel was at the island, Bourayne's officers examined the ship and figured out that it wouldn't be any match to his ship. So as soon as it left the island, they chased it down and captured it. He then used the Laurel as his own ship to help capture other British vessels. And then after those battles, his ship had been damaged, and so it was basically decommissioned. And on his return to mainland France, he was captured by the British. While in captivity, Napoleon raised him to the title of Baron of Empire. And then after Napoleon's defeat, he again served the French monarchy and was still in active service when he died in 1817. So now let's take a look at some of the actual finer details on these pistols. So if you look pretty much from muzzle all the way to the pommel, there's very little of the metal that isn't embellished with gold. And you can see there's a large variety of designs. You've got some meandering patterns, you've got lots of floral patterns, you've got this lightning motif up top for Jupiter. If you look here on the pommels, you've got a mask of Neptune, which is very fitting for a naval captain. On the wrists, you actually have Bourayne's family seal. And if you look, as I pointed out before, the overall style, the architecture of the pistol itself is a little more classic French. But when you get into the finer details, a lot of them have some Greco-Roman, even Egyptian style designs. You can see the turbans and crescent moons on the trigger guard. And it's got some urn style and decoration here that you kind of see in classic Roman architecture. And that is largely due to the fact that Napoleon was basically obsessed with ancient Rome. He considered himself, you know, emulating the Roman emperors. And you can see basically all of the gold remains. A lot of the gold is very bright. And then the locks actually retain really strong nitre blue, which is you don't really see very often on pistols this old. They've seen very little use, very little wear. They've been very well preserved. And they're easily going to be among the most valuable Boutet firearms in existence today. And so next we'll talk about this interesting little piece here. At first, this looks like a nice French pocket pistol. Again, it's kind of got a classic French styling. You got some nice Rococo style carving. You've got wire inlays and lots of cool gold motifs. But actually, if you flip the frizzen open, it's a lighter. So the way this would work is the flint would come crashing down in the frizzen. You'd have a little bit of powder in the pan that would light, and then that would actually light some tinder. And then from there you could light, you know, a little candle or a wick, and then you could use that to start your kindling or light some other candles, things of that nature. And one of the things that's kind of neat about this piece, aside from the fact that it's you know, looks like a pistol but isn't a pistol, is these are actually really rare. You find some of these as early as the 1760s, but there's not a lot of surviving examples. So this was actually probably made as a gift. If you look, it's got, you know, a coat of arms style here, and then throughout it's got mostly romantic motifs. So you've got Cupid's arrows, you've got kissing birds, and Cupid's arrows and bow, that theme continues from here onto the pommel cap and on the trigger guard as well. So it kind of continues throughout. And this would be a very appropriate gift for, you know, a gentleman, maybe that travels a lot or something like that, or even a lady. And like, you know, the fancy officer's presentation pieces, these also have some Greco-Roman designs. You've got, in addition to Cupid, you've got some lightning motifs here, and you've got some floral emblems and an eagle. So overall, a very nice, very interesting looking piece. You don't see things like this very often. I believe this is the first we've ever sold. We've sold other tinder lighters, but not one that works like this. And it's definitely the most ornate one we've sold. In keeping with the theme of things that are probably made as a gift, this beautiful light smoothbore hunting gun here was probably made for a lady. Its overall build is very small. Even for the French, it's got some fairly feminine style designs on it, lots of flowers and urns, and you can see it's very graceful, it's very light. It's got a lyre guitar engraved here on the butt plate heel. And then down on the bottom, just like the lighter, you got some kissing birds, Cupid's arrows, some more musical instruments. And overall, lots of really fine designs. The wood is beautifully shaped. You can see the comb's got some nice fluting right here. And then up on top, again, you've got gold, extends up here by the muzzle. And around the front sight, you got another set of bands here, the pan is lined, and then everything is pretty much engraved in classic French style. And on this example, unlike these pistols, you can clearly see the Boutet markings and the Versailles markings. All right, and so the last set we have here is probably the most emblematic of the Empire style of all these pistols. So if you look at this pair, it's got the really sharp wrist angle. So whereas earlier pistols kind of angled out like this, this is a nice, more modern style pistol grip. It's got beautiful architecture. The shape, it points very naturally like you expect from like a dueling style pistol. And again, this one does have the Boutet Versailles markings on the lock visible. And then if you look carefully, it's also got Boutet up here on top and off to the side here. And then it also has Boutet à Versailles along the upper flats of the barrel. And everything about these pistols, all of these arms are finely crafted. This pistol probably shows off that the best in terms of, if you look at the sighting groove, it's very clean. The edges are all very clean and sharp. The way the inlays meet with the metal, there's no, you can't feel it. It's very smooth. Everything's flush and very distinct. All the engraving is very detailed. You know, it's got all kinds of finer points. If you look at the style of the mainspring with the frizzen roller, it's got a set trigger, it's got a spurred trigger guard, which helps you with when you steady the pistol. And if I was to pull these locks out, which obviously I'm not gonna be able to do during a video, but if you pull these out, the way they inlet these locks, they literally inlet around the mainspring. So whereas you might see some military arms where they basically like hog out the whole inside of the inlet, these are very, very, very precisely inletted around the mainsprings. So while Boutet oversaw the production of over 600,000 arms, things like this are obviously going to be a much smaller percentage of that, but they're also his most famous works. And you can tell why. I mean, these are easily some of the finest firearms in French history. They're very ornate. Every detail is very finely done. And they were presented to both dignitaries and military officers within the French Empire and also without. They gave them to foreign dignitaries and whatnot, especially allies, to cement Napoleon's power in Europe. You can find really high-end Boutet pistols and firearms like this and really prestigious collections around the world, including the Met, private collections. All of the guns here before me actually came out of the Gerald Klaas collection, which is actually a very impressive array of both Smith & Wessons and really high-end antique European arms like these. And these are the kinds of guns that make superb, you know, investments. Each one of these guns is a work of art. You can see that they're in high condition. They got a lot of details. There's a lot to love in each one of these guns. So be sure to check out our catalog online and in print. And come check out our auction on April 24th, 25th, and 26th. Mm-hmm.